What up, everyone? Before we get started, more news on the two last topics I spoke about on the last video. One, we're just on the verge of releasing my next album, The Daydream Sound 3. That is the tentative title. The actual slated title is called The Origin of Silence. And that continues the whole theme of the kids, Atsu and Carwin, from the story Passage to a Kevalon that was written on the last album. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, it's probable that one, you're just new to this channel, and two, you have not bought my album, which includes the ebook that contains the story of these two children and all the other characters. So of course, on my website and on this YouTube channel and everywhere, you'll see cartoon characters. And if you're wondering what they are, they belong to a story that belongs to the ebook that you get with the album. And my albums, The Daydream Sound 1 and 2, are actually scores for these stories. And The Origin of Silence, my album slated for next month, continues this story, gives you more information about the twins, the robot, and all the other characters, and I'm looking forward to sharing that with you. Second order of business is the Daydream Sound Classic t-shirt line that I have coming out summer 2014. I'm going to be posting probably right after this video or tomorrow a commercial about the t-shirt line. I have prototype samples of just the layout of what the t-shirt will look like and more that I'll be posting on Facebook and so on and so forth as the days roll by up until summer. So check back on the channel here tomorrow and on Facebook for more insight on the t-shirts. Now on to the topic of this video. Throughout this video, I'm just going to go over points of things that would be helpful to anyone who wants more out of their life, out of their career, and would prefer to work for themselves over an employer. And most importantly, an employer that supplies a job that has nothing to do with your goals in life. Listen, you can't hold on to your music. I don't care how good you think the song is. It's best to let people hear it. Anyone hear it. Anyone within earshot needs to hear what you're doing. That is the only way that they're going to speak about you. And that's the only way they're going to know the caliber of your work. You also have to make music. In making music is practice. It's training. It's how you strengthen your skill as a musician. Believe that you can get better, and you will. And I think this stems back to holding on to music. Sometimes you make a beat or a song and you somehow feel that there's no way you're going to be able to top that. So you end up placing so much value on that song that it sort of cripples any idea that you can actually do something better. And I've gotten into the mindset of the fact that I can always make another beat. I don't care how good the last song was that I made. I can always make another one, and I'm convinced of this. So when it comes to making music, I don't have any pressure going into it. Whatever I make is what it is. If it's good, it's good. If it's not, it's not. Either way, I don't care. And that's allowed me to be more productive overall, because I'm not placing so much value on what I'm doing. What I'm placing value in is my ability to do it. And that mindset breeds confidence in your own innate ability to be creative. Also, if you want to get better, your scope and your taste in music have to broaden. You can't limit yourself to the type of music you make as your primary taste in music. You have to like all types of music. More importantly, it's a complete waste of time to hate on any style of music that you don't like. There's a lot of people out there that hate Lil Wayne, they hate Drake, they hate any new artist that's out right now. And it's mostly old farts like me who have this mindset. And the thing about all that is, if you don't like something, number one, you have a choice not to listen to it. But number two, you have to realize that this music is for kids. And the fact is, all the artists that I've just mentioned above relate very well to children and what they're doing. At the very least, it would be best for you to pay attention to why these kids relate so well to these new artists. Rather than discussing how much you don't like them, it would be a smart move to pay attention to why other people do like them. Because there's clearly a difference between what children like and what adults like. So for you to spend so much time evaluating what children like as an adult, honestly, is a very immature thing to do. Kids like what kids like, and you have to give children the space and the option to like whatever appeals to them. Now on to the idea of music as a career. The general consensus is that being a musician these days isn't even considered to be a career path. But I'd like to propose this. Musicians and artists in general have some of the longest career lifespans known to man. A musician can perform, write, and be an artist from childhood and continue that career path until they die. So much so that most of the biggest musicians in our time never retired. They performed literally up until the day they died. Now you compare that to a corporate day job. Which one of you out there would be happy to work a standard corporate job for the rest of your life until the day you died? So my end question is, do you think your music is good enough to provide a lifelong career for you. Because fortunately, when it comes to being an artist, age has nothing to do with it. You can be just as effective, if not better, at 85 than you can be at 25. Also, if you're not seriously trying to pursue music as a career, stop fooling yourself and everybody else into believing that's what you want. Stop right now, pack your gear up, sell it, do whatever you have to do, and get out of the way. And you can fall back into the millions and millions of worker bees who desire nothing more than to work 80 hours a week at a day job that has nothing to do with the benefit of your personal well-being. Because here's the thing. Right now, there's too much music out there. And a lot of it is bad. And a lot of it is made by people who just have the option to make music. And I'm not saying that you can't have music as a hobby. But when you want to get people to invest in you, and you have no plan or no intention to follow through, you're wasting time. And it's fine if you want to waste your own time, but don't waste the attention and time of others. And even more so, realize that when you procrastinate and you flip-flop on what you want to do with your life, you can lose your entire soul, literally, by avoiding and suppressing what you're meant to do. For example, I live here in Toronto, and it's a pretty big, busy city. And on any given day, you can go downtown, which I am a lot, and you will see people walking around. And if you take the time to actually look in their eyes, they're like walking zombies. You can tell that the only thing on their mind is getting to work, working, going home, paying bills, and trying to survive. There is no indication of happiness in their eyes. There's no trace of well-being. And these aren't poor people I'm talking about. These are people with good jobs. These are people that are financially stable. But the problem is they behave as if they're being controlled by a remote. And effectively they are. And the person who's holding the remote is their employer. So I say all that to say, it's actually your responsibility to create happiness for yourself. And unfortunately, you will be held accountable by yourself for not doing this. So what do I mean? You can actually create sickness in yourself by not being happy. Have you ever felt stressed to go to work? Have you ever felt the pressure of overwhelming demands from a work environment that you don't want to be in? I've seen people lose their hair, lose sleep, lose their appetite from being stressed out at their job that pays them very well, their job that allows them to pay their bills and have tons of expendable cash to do whatever it is they want. But all of that takes a backseat to the fact that they're not happy. And so sickness begins to manifest in your body. And that's actually your brain and every fiber of your being telling you, look, I'm not happy. You got to change whatever it is you're doing right now, or else we're not going to make it. So always remember this, and always keep this in mind. Anyone who tells you simply to work to pay your bills is a minion and a slave to the interests of those who understand what the game of life is about. And unfortunately, some who know what the game of life is about have no problem exploiting those who don't. In addition, to make better music, try real hard to be original. And when I say be original, just try being comfortable with yourself. What would half of you do out there if you didn't have your favorite artist style to jack? You know, if you were the only person on earth with the ability to make music for some reason, what would you make? If your favorite producer didn't exist, would you even like music? Would you see making your own original music too difficult or too boring? If so, it's highly likely and highly probable that deep down inside, you find yourself boring. And because of that, you might possibly believe that everyone else just might find you boring. Your lack of interest in yourself is a reflection of how you see yourself. And so what you end up doing is trying your best to emulate an artist who's garnered a lot of interest and attention for themselves, and you hope that your emulations will resonate sympathetically from the huge buzz that they've created for themselves. And as crazy as that sounds, artists do that all the time. There's nothing wrong with liking another artist's work. There's nothing wrong with trying to pick apart how another artist works. There is something wrong when you flat out copy with no shame everything that that artist does, to the point where there's virtually no difference between that artist and yourself. So in summary, and I sincerely mean this, believe in yourself and you won't be able to lose. Every single successful person in life does so because they actually believe in what they're doing. And it doesn't matter if anybody else believes. As long as you believe, there really won't be much to stop you in life. As always, thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Subscribe to me here on YouTube. Friend me on Facebook. Let me know your thoughts about what you think about what I've said here on this video. Buy my albums, The Daydream Sound 1 and 2, at thedaydreamsound.com. Take care of yourselves. Peace. I would like to get to black. Get to black. I would like to get to low. Get to black. I would